This video brought to you by our Patreons. Please consider supporting this channel and joining our Patreons at patreon.com/NovaWing24. Hi there folks, my name's NovaWing24 and welcome to the NovaWrap, your one-stop location for your simulation release news and goings-on from the week that was. So here we are on Sunday the 9th of May 2021 for another exciting episode of new releases from the simulation world. And let's get straight into it for one that is technically just from the week before, but I really want to highlight this one because I'm actually really excited about this one. So this comes to us from developer Fly Inside as they release their first, not only their first product for Microsoft Flight Simulator, but their first aircraft, I believe, from this particular developer's history. And I've got to admit, I'm stupidly impressed by it. Of course, we are talking about the release of the Fly Inside Bell 47 G2 for Microsoft Flight Simulator, the first helicopter, payware helicopter for Microsoft Flight Simulator. Now, I can hear you going, but wait, Nova, there isn't supposed to be proper helicopters in Microsoft Flight Simulator until 2022. What gives? Well, that's a really good question, and I'm not going to lie, I was kind of skeptical myself when I first heard about it. But I was convinced to give it a try by my good friend Sergio over at helisimmer.com, and all I have to say is wow. So it's been a really interesting technical journey as well, is that the developer Fly Inside have gone through the SDK with a fine tooth comb. And although it is absolutely correct that officially there is no helicopter flight model inside of Microsoft Flight Simulator at this time, one of the interesting things about the SDK is that there is portals and openings there for developers that, if they want to do things the right way, actually can inject their own custom flight model or manipulate a lot more variables than we used to be able to in legacy sims. Now, what the team at Fly Inside have done, because they have a lot of experience of getting inside the nitty-gritty of how simulators work, of course, they are most famous for being the first to bring VR to FSX and to Prepared before Prepared natively started supporting VR with later versions of it. So Fly Inside very much have got used to be able to get inside simulator, get inside the SDKs, and be able to work with the core sim code. So they've been able to do that. They've done that previously. They've shown their legacy there. And they've taken that experience and applied it to working with a helicopter. Now, originally, this helicopter was supposed to be for their own flight sim, because the team at Fly Inside have actually been working on making their own flight sim for a number of years. So originally this helicopter was destined for that sim, but they're taking the opportunity to bring it to life first for Microsoft Flight Simulator, and I've got to admit that I'm not normally a helicopter person, but this thing is so much fun. Yes, it is a very basic helicopter. Yes, absolutely correct. You know, there's nothing fancy about this helicopter. This is a piston helicopter. This is a piston engine, relic, your first, very much a first generation helicopter here. But it is something that it nails all the fundamentals. You know, all the fundamentals of rotorcraft operations are nailed with part of this, as part of this aircraft and this particular custom flight model. And it is incredibly challenging. Like, it absolutely is. And having talked to people who are far more used to flying helicopters, both IRL and in various different sims, they've all pretty much unanimously said that this is an incredible rendition of it. And it definitely gets that challenge going for the actual intricacies and unique challenges posed by helicopter flying. Now, in terms of the actual product itself, I mean, the modeling is amazing, high-quality modeling, 4K textures throughout, full PBR throughout, all the usual fun stuff that we come to expect now. The lighting model, basic but great, it works. Animations are great. For the test flights I've taken in, a lot of fun. Incredibly difficult, like in ease. So I will say, sort of easy to get in to get access to it, but it's incredibly difficult to master. There are three different levels of flight model that are actually offered. And then you can customize certain elements within that as well. And it is also optimized because helicopters have very unique sets of controls and actually really subsequently have five, six axes of control. But there's a setup in there where it'll actually allow you to have an auto governor in there so you don't have to. Those of us who just have traditional HOTAS setups with rudder pedals, we can still fly helicopters without having to have that extra axis of control. So really incredible, great work from the team. I do highly recommend it. I took it for a test flight in live on air with on stream, and I managed not to die, which was a pretty impressive feat. But yeah, it looks incredible. Now, there are a couple of quirks and a couple of bugs with it, mostly to do with the integration with the Asobo Pilot models, but it is fully VR compliant, a highly detailed 3D model, fully VR compliant, and just overall looks amazing, sounds amazing as well. Includes a variety of failures as well, if you want to have failures turned on, and custom flight dynamics for flight physics included in there as well, including all major sort of helicopter flight unique physics, including translational lift, ground effect, translar flow, auto rotation, vortex ring state, and a variety of, and retreating blade stall features are all modeled as well. Like, this thing is nuts. Like, it is absolutely insane. I have enough problems just trying to keep this thing fly in the air. So for those who actually, you know, want to engage like a lot of the failures and the full, you know, the full realism flight model on it, good luck to you, because this thing is going to challenge you really, really well. This one's available. So this one, you can pick this one now from direct from the Fly Inside website for $35 US or your original equivalent, available now from Fly Inside. Continuing on with the releases for scenery. Again, a lot of scenery releases for Microsoft Flight Simulator this week from the team at Aerosoft. Saw two releases this week. The first one we saw was the release of Airport Zagreb, which of course is Croatia's capital and their main airport. The airport is named after Franjo Tudman, which is Croatia's first president. It includes a highly detailed rendition of the airport as it appears in the beginning of 2021, including all new terminal buildings, most with interior designs as well, on models both civilian and the military side of the airport, including custom photo of the airport and surrounding area. A variety of custom external points of interest, including the TV tower Selgeme and the old ruins of Medvegrad, are also included as well. Includes a fully sloped runway as well, sloped a runway and apron as well, which is kind of cool. So it's not just about the apron, the runway anymore. Animated radar antenna, animated windsocks, and a full set of custom lighting models included as well. Full PBR and night lighting support throughout, as we would expect as well. Custom catering truck and boarding stairs also used throughout the airport services as well. And you can pick this one up for $18 US or your original equivalent, available now from Aerosoft. And the other release from Aerosoft via Stairport Sceneries this week saw the release of their rendition of Perranporth Airfield in Cornwall. It's in the southwestern tip of England, a small country airfield dating back to being a Royal Air Force station during the Second World War. Now used as a GA and glider launching airfield now. It includes an accurate rendition of the airport as it appears in 2021, including all airport buildings and custom terrain objects included as well, including the rendition of the Cornwall Cliffs as well, which gives you a challenging approach. So watch out for that updraft as you come over on short final on that one as well. A variety of custom 3D objects, custom static aircraft also included, as long with real traffic at the airport as well, and designed to be blended seamlessly into the UK World Update as well. You can pick this one up for $10 US or your original equivalent, available now from Aerosoft. Continuing with very much the UK theme there, I saw this with the release from Orbix of their rendition of Carnarvon Airport in Wales. So this is a GA airfield that originally used to be a bomber base during the Second World War. So it's also the home to a search and rescue helicopter services throughout the area as well. Includes custom ground poly, custom aerial imagery for the airport and surrounding area as well. Custom 3D all airport buildings and airport layout as appears at the start of 2021. Including accurately modelled airport buildings and landside buildings as well, with a variety of 3D fencing, signage, and equipment also tailored for this area as well. Designed to work seamlessly with the UK World Update 3 as well, and the UK North POI region as well. and looking pretty awesome. Going to be great when we get some bigger, the bigger helicopters as well. One of the cool things about this airport as well, by the way, folks, is the fact that one of the so it's really interesting. There's two whopping great wind turbines in the middle of the airfield. So one of the runways is closed because of that, and the other one, I wouldn't want to be landing in a crosswind because your wings might whack the base of the turbines. So yeah, just really interesting. I reviewed this airport from another developer previously for Legacy Sims. So excited to give this one a try out. It is actually also part of the Skypark UK tour as well. So if you haven't got haven't done the Skypark tour, or if you have and you want to go back and see what this airport is, you may have seen the airport. It's in the photo reel that the wind turbines were there, but it's great that they've actually got an airport with them in there now. It's kind of cool. Anyway, so yeah, if you want to pick this one up, this one is available now from Always Direct for $13 or original equivalent, available now. Continuing on with scenery releases, this time from developer FSDG, and moving out from the colds of Europe into the beautiful sunny Caribbean with the release of St. Lucia from FSDG. So this is, of course, the home of the Pirates of the Caribbean movie series. But this particular airport has a highly detailed rendition of George F. L. Charles Airport in St. Lucia with a full detailed rendition of the airport. I believe this is mostly a port over from the previous release of this airport, though, so I think it's, I believe it's the layout as it was in 2020, might even be 2019. Includes custom landmarks of the surrounding area as well as all airport buildings modeled in high definition modeling and 4K and high definition textures as well. Includes static ship and static ships in the harbour as well as aircraft at the airport as well. Include full support for dynamic lighting and custom ground materials and ground polys as well. And you can pick this one up for $15 or your original equivalent, available now from FSDG. Moving away from scenery, moving on to Discovery Flights, the developer Perfect Flight saw the release of their latest Discovery Flights series with their release of their France and Benelux Discovery Flights series of bush trips. So this one gives five Discovery Flights, or for five bush trip missions, giving you exhaustive tours of France, Belgium, Luxembourg, Netherlands, and the Paris area, with over 100 points of interest documented and photos available in the navigation log. Includes full custom text-to-speech technology and custom flight plans included for each of the bush flights. Well, that's kind of a given. It really kind of is. It also includes two new liveries, for one each for the DA-60 and one for the DA-40 and next generation included as well. So these missions are looking pretty cool, like some vary in length from sort of 30 minutes up to sort of it's really kind of interesting actually. So there's four of the five, four of them are fairly short, sort of 30 minutes to a couple of hours, and then there's one which goes through the entire of France, and that one is 2,500 nautical miles in 21 legs and is estimated to take you about 16 hours. So that's kind of cool. That one could be a fun one to do. So if you wanted to really get the full benefit out of your pack, this one might actually give you that one. So you can pick this one up for $15 or your original equivalent, available now from PC Aviator. Moving out of Microsoft Flight Simulator, moving into the world of the legacy ESP sims, I saw this week the release from Turbine Sound Studios of their latest sound set in the form of their Embraer 195 GECF34 Pilot Edition sound package. So this sound package gives a full set of new recordings for both internal and external engine sounds, a variety of new custom layered wind sounds, a variety of other updates and sound sets for the feature packs as well. Now, although this is designed to this is optimized to work with the feel there Embraer 195, it is theoretically able to work with any ESP platform Embraer 195 model as well. And you pick this one up for $20 or your original equivalent, available now from PC Aviator. Moving out of the ESP Sims and moving into the world of X-Plane with another release that was technically last week, but I did want to show this one off because I love this aeroplane and I really want to highlight it because I think it's a cool aeroplane. It really is. So this is this week we saw the release from Just Flight. of their 146 Professional for X-Plane 11. Now, previously, they have released this one for prepared V4 and V5, but this time they've partnered once again with famed X-Plane developer Thuranda Designs to be able to bring it across successfully over onto the X-Plane 11 platform. So this is a highly detailed rendition of the of eight variants of the BAE 146, including the 100, 200, and 300 series passenger aircraft, the 200, 300 cargo variants, as well as two military variations, including the VIP and the cargo configuration models as well. All of these are based extensively off three real-world aeroplanes, airframes, including full custom sound sets, custom high-accurate 3D models, including externals and interiors, a full set of custom jump positions, fully VR compatible now as well for the X-Plane 11, as well as custom throttle logic, custom engines logic and engine program parameters as well, and a full sort of other features as well. Overall, looking pretty damn amazing. And if you are wanting to get the experience of a of airliners before the days of fly-by-wire and fancy glass cockpits, this might be the quiet trader might be the aircraft challenge that you might be looking for. And you pick this one up for $75 US or your original equivalent, available now from Just Flights. Moving out of the flight sim world and moving into simulation of a very different kind, saw this week to release from Arma 3 of their, what I believe is their first creator DLC series, which was the release this week of SOG Prairie Fire. Now, this marks a fairly significant, there's a lot going on to unpack with this. Now, apart from this looking absolutely amazing, like the models, Arma 3 has always been known for its engagement and much for its realism in terms of its sort of first-person combat simulation. But it also has an underlying amazing helicopter flight simulation model in there as well, by the way. Like, for that alone, it's a pretty amazing. There's a lot to unpack here with this one as well, because traditionally Arma 3 has always been on this borderline of it's real but it's not kind of thing, where things are not exactly what they are in real life. They're just that 10% different to make them just different enough so they don't have to do anything. This is the first time we've actually seen them recreate something officially, as at least anyway, of something historical, at least for the Arma 3 franchise, as far as I'm aware. I might be wrong, and I do apologize if I am, but from my research, that's what it looks like. Now, this recreates a series of operations during the Vietnam War, undertaken along the borders of Vietnam, Laos, and Cambodia. And it goes back through a series of operations and it follows the story of a special operations group, and they're called Prairie Fire. A lot going across here, a lot of really interesting thing here. Huge, there's a huge campaign map there of over 300 square kilometers of terrain, including a US Air Force base, a 6 forward operating base, and a variety of other features including various things, parts of the Ho Chi Minh Trail, a variety of SAM sites, boats on the Mekong Delta. Like, there is so much going on in this DLC. It is absolutely insane. Custom authentic units, vehicles, weapons, helicopters throughout, and a single aircraft being a F4 Phantom 2 also done as well. So there is an insane amount of stuff here. I'm not going to go unpack it all through here, but it is looking absolutely amazing. And even I have picked this one up because I'm really, really think this one looks incredible. Like, it just looks absolutely nuts. And this one's coming in for $20 US or your original equivalent, available now from Steam. And rounding out the NovaWrap this week with simulation of a very different kind this week. This week is a release from developer Playway, publisher Playway Simulations and Sim Farms. We saw the release this week of Farm Manager 2021. Now, this is, I didn't know what to think of this one when I first looked at this one, and I'll be honest, I still actually don't know what to think about this. This seems to be not the farm sim I was expecting, and I guess I should have expected that from Farm Manager not being Farm Simulator. So this is probably more about a bigger picture. It's almost like a Sim City style farming sim rather than a more hands-on of actual farming simulator. So I left it in here because it is still simulating, just on a different level, this one here. So I don't really know much about it, I'll be honest. It looks like you can do a lot more. Like, you can actually, you can sort of nominate machinery, you can nominate your animal types, you can get special buildings, you actually lay out the way your town and your farm and your farm or farms are actually laid out, and roads, electricity, lighting as well. So there's a lot more of that city building part of it than just going out and plowing fields. So if you're more into the hands-on, you want to go out and plow the fields, this probably isn't going to be the simulation game for you. If you're more into the city building genre side of things, and maybe economic manager simulation, then this might be the one that you might want to check out. So if you want to pick this one up, you can pick this one up for $20 US or your original equivalent, available now on Steam. And with that, folks, that does now round out the NovaWrap for this week. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget, as always, to like the video and subscribe to the channel if you're enjoying these videos and want to see more. And of course, as always, you can catch up with me and all the things I'm up to between videos by finding me on Facebook and on Twitter. Just search NovaWing24. All right, folks, thanks very much for watching. Take care, safe skies to all, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.